wish.
One of the joys of working on a musical for film is that you get to rehearse.
I wish.
And one of the byproducts of that rehearsal is you create a company. And that's a really special thing.
Into the woods and down the dell, the path is straight, I know it well. Into the woods and who can tell what's waiting on the journey.
When I turned 40, I was offered 3 witches within 1 year. And I thought, okay, this is the way my career is gonna go. So I said no to playing witches. But then this came along, and this witch is quite different.
Don't ever, never, ever mess around with my greens. Especially the beans.
You come in and you know, you're incredibly nervous, and then there's the moment where you all have to sort of sing in front of each other, and you're like, well, there's Meryl Streep, and she's singing, and she's amazing, and, you know, you're just trying not to be fired, really. That was my experience the first 2 weeks, just trying to step up, really.
I think across the board, everybody was just feeling like, how did I sneak into this cast?
It makes absolutely everyone want to be completely on their game.
Just feeling so lucky to be there.
It's your fault, you're responsible, you're the one to blame, it's your fault.
What's been fantastic about doing the film as opposed to a stage production of Into the Woods is that we have a real cow. Her name is Tug, and I'm in love with my cow. I take pictures of her, I Instagram me with my cow, and I say, look, 2 old cows.
Who cares? Cow's gone. Get it back.
One of my philosophies about casting is that ultimately, if you do it right, you actually don't have to make the choice. It's made for you.
Rob is the perfect guy to do this and to be able to envision it and to translate that vision to the actors, making us feel comfortable and free.
I should have laid a spell on them right there.
I didn't even want to audition for this. I was so frightened and embarrassed about singing in front of people.
I honestly thought Emily Blunt would be perfection in this role. Just never seen her sing. You know, musicals are few and far between, so you don't know whether people can do it.
Was that him? Yes, it was. Was that me? No, it wasn't. Just a trick of the woods.
Something that I was embarrassed to do became one of the most fulfilling experiences of my entire life. Getting to play this part and sing with confidence and complexity. It was just so thrilling.
And to get what you wish only just for a moment, these are dangerous words.
We did about 6 weeks rehearsals where we were just in an empty rehearsal room using kind of very standard props, you know, cardboard trees and things like that. And for a while it felt like we were just putting on some strange touring production of Into the Woods. It just so happened to have all of these movie stars in it.
He has this incredible humor and physical comedy, and he can sing.
When it comes to the baking, I feel like if the film works, that could be a real side project that I really get into. You know, croissants and pain au chocolat.
It's this crazy combination of things you ask actors to do in a musical.
Let's sing with your track, just to have one, and then the next one we'll do. Maybe you can sing live.
Okay, great.
Yeah. I really love No One Is Alone as a song. I just think the message in the song is just beautiful.
You are not alone.
That's almost the message of the film in a way.
No one. He made me cry every time.
Don't believe me.
It's sort of this really healing moment for these two characters.
No one is alone.
Some moments have been really choreographed beautifully by Rob Marshall and John DeLuca, and Tug has gotten better and better and better.
Milky White, you're back! I believe it!
I grew up with a copy of Into the Woods, and to be honest, mostly I wanted to be Little Red because I was very young when I saw it. And so when I found out that they were making this into a movie, it was actually weird to wrap my brain around the idea that I would be, you know, auditioning for and then playing Cinderella, not Little Red Riding Hood.
You wish to go to the festival?
Everything's in place for her to be just the perfect Cinderella. But if you're asking me as a character, I don't think the stepmother thinks of her that way at all.
To have Christine Baranski as my wicked stepmother is so fun.
The festival!
In today's world, the stepmother would be Botoxed and have, you know, inflated lips and lots of Versace and chained handbags and lots of jewelry, and would be, you know, probably cleavage, trying to keep up with her daughters, trying to look 20 years younger. It's that kind of like, they're trying so hard.
Come along, ladies.
Yes, Mother.
Good luck.
What Rob and I tried to do was just honor that kind of brave, thoughtful, neurotic Cinderella. I get my prince, but, you know, that kind of goes wrong. So I guess she's like a couple's therapist dream.
The ball is over. Send everyone home.
And the princess?
She won't get far with one shoe.
One of my favorite lines that he has.
I was raised to be charming, not sincere.
Essentially sums up the character, and he knows no other way of being.
Have you seen a beautiful young woman in a ball gown, pastoral?
I'd really like to play Prince Charming, because he's just such a moron.
Agony! Oh, the torture they teach!
Chris and Billy, they're such hunks, you know, they're such jocks. They're so kind of cosmetically perfect, but they're goofballs and they're wonderfully funny.
I remember getting the audition. Meryl Streep, I kind of owe it to her, saw me in a play I did in New York, and I think called Rob and said, go check out this kid, I think he would be good. I got out here and they were like, here, get on that horse, learn how to ride it, start singing lessons. And my job's riding some horses and singing, like that's exciting.
Ah! Nope, bad idea.
What's beautiful about what Meryl Streep's done with this witch that I'm so proud of is that she has really made her a full flesh and blood person with vulnerabilities and fears and truth, which only Meryl Streep can do.
Roy Helland created two very distinct looks for the witch and the witch transformed.
Meryl has very little makeup on. She really wanted to transform physically herself. And Roy knows to get out of the way and let that happen because he knows he's working with this amazing actor.
I was watching you crawl back over the wall when bang, crash, a lightning flash.
And cut. Beautiful. You're unbelievable, Meryl.
I mean, it's pretty much her. There's a little bit of a chin and a little bit of a brow. And it was enough. I mean, you do have Meryl Streep.
What? Midnight gone!
Already?
Get the cow! Get it!
I just love being with the cow. And I scratch the cow and I stroke the cow. But if I stop scratching her and I'm talking, she's just like my dog. She goes...
When Rob asked if I would be interested in doing Into the Woods and playing the big bad wolf, it was real scary because it's the second time I'm going to sing in my life again, which I swore I'd never do. And it's Sondheim again.
Diving in themselves, they were all scared. It's outside of their comfort zones. So when you watch it, they're so alive in every moment.
Hello, little girl. What's your rush? You're missing all the flowers.
Lilla Crawford, who plays Little Red Riding Hood, we had seen her in Annie. And she was fantastic. How can someone that little be that good an actor?
Oh, dear. How uneasy I feel.
She's kind of way ahead of her years, which is exactly what Little Red should be anyway.
She's a great singer, certainly, but she followed right along with some of the more physicalities of what I, you know, felt would be fun. Because it's almost like doing a silent film in a way, you know. The idea instinctively comes to you to just sort of grab her by the hood and drag her back or give her a little shove.
He just goes out there and, you know, he has the most amazing ideas. I'm just the tiniest little bit starstruck where it's kind of like, am I talking to Johnny Depp? I am. Whoa, that's amazing. Goodbye, Mr. Wolf.
Goodbye, little girl.
I really wanted to cast kids because for me, this piece is very much about parents and children. And I really wanted to make sure that both Little Red Riding Hood and Jack were played by kids.
There are giants in the sky. There are big, tall, terrible giants in the sky.
Goes on. I want to climb up this massive tree in there. It's like really cool.
The character of Jack is usually played on stage by someone older, usually in their late teens or early 20s. And Daniel was 13 at the time. He sings Giants in the Sky completely in a whole nother register because his voice at that point had not changed. And it's beautiful to hear that like that. It's so wonderful. And he's so disarming. And as Meryl Streep said, a real actor. And she's right.
There are big, tall, terrible, awesome, scary, wonderful giants in the sky.
Rob is joyous about the work he does, and that joy is infectious,
and permeates each and every actor and each and every performance.
It's a beautiful result, and I hope they give me the cow.
Oh!